25 people will come, and he will be one of those who come. He was a small boy, very small. That was 1976. 76. No. Yeah, somewhere like that, 76. He used to come and he used to ask, and he was the only fellow who will ask me, why not this, why not that. Sometimes his questions were correct, but often they were correct. Often his questions were correct, not incorrect. So I couldn't answer why this is not good or why that's not bad. So I knew he was a good talent, but at the same time I thought he was a damn nuisance. Because he won't let me finish that thing. I would have said, I must take this much of things. But if I'm answering his questions, I cannot complete it.
And so when you played against him, did you feel like he will become like the world champion and the great name that he is today?
No, I knew he will become a great player. Because in both games, he was in the losing against me. And both games he turned around and won. And I believe that a person who fights back and wins is a potential champion. And a very good player. Only an ordinary fellow will run away in the face of adversity.
Usually chess players, they are not so interested to get into administration. But you did, and you spread chess in a big way. How did that happen?
I think that's my family trait. My father used to do that. He was always interested in the public. What we can do for this people, that people, and all that. And I thought there were so many things rotten in the administration of chess admission at that time. So I thought somebody must do something about it. I remember Mahalingam was the... When I first became secretary of the Tamil Nadu Association, Mahalingam was president. And the secretary at the time was one T.T. Krishnasamy, a chartered accountant. With his help only, we held the national team championship in Kanyakumari. This was some year, long back. And I was against TTK, because I think TTK was not doing anything. And then I thought he was swindling money. But all players think like that about the administrators, all players. If there's any question about something, they'll say, okay, the secretary is a chore, the president is a chore. Whether knowing whether true or not, quite often I know a lot of people put in their own hard-earned money and time for nothing into an administration because they think it's for the public good. I did it because I thought it's good for chess and people will appreciate me. That's about all. That's all. And I put my money also in it quite often. My wife still says that I do that.
What were some of the things that you changed in Indian chess once you were into the administration?
I brought in some things like which is abroad, some systems of play and things like that. Which when I go and visit some country, we play something. I know certain things why chess has become so popular in America, but here it is not that popular because you don't need a sponsor in America to run a tournament. You advertise a huge prize money, go and work for a hotel and tell the hotel, we'll occupy so many rooms, you give us the meeting hall or conference hall free of cost, and they are happy to fill their rooms and give you this thing free, and people are also going to eat there. So the hotels are happy, the players come there, stay there and eat, and if they don't before a particular time, then they have to go stay somewhere else and pay a higher cost. That sort of thing they have. So, in America, when a tournament is over, you just go and tell the tournament director, sir, my name is this, I scored so many points. You look into the chart, if you got the prize, immediately write out a check and give you, over. No ceremony, nothing. There's nobody to please with. Only if they go and beg and get some money from somebody, they have to please him. Here, they don't have to please anybody. You start your games right, exactly on time. Everything is very clockwork precision in the US. But not in our country. Here we have to wait for the chief guest to come, the chief guest to go, and all that sort of thing. We have to garden, we have to talk a lot about. Sometimes we talk bad things, I mean, untrue things also about the chief guest. Virtues ascribed to him which are not existent.
And then you started one of the biggest magazines in Indian chess, the Chess Mate.
Yeah.
And can you tell us something about that?
When I was secretary of the AACF, there was the National Chess Trust of India. It was founded by LN Junjunwala, the boss of Bilwara. He's still the boss, he's still alive. And he started that thing, and he and I, we didn't get on well. And now I know why exactly. See, BHEL Bhopal wanted to organize a tournament, and these people have approached BHEL Bhopal, who Junjunwala's Bilwara, they are approaching. Earlier, one Bilwara tournament was held here in Chennai. The condition was they'll give only the prize money, 10,000 rupees or so total at that time. Only the association had to find the first class train tickets for all the players. At the time, it was first class train tickets for all the invitees. It was only a 10-12 player tournament for all the invitees. Put them in a good hotel, pay them the food, and only the prize money they will give. But actually, the other things will come to more than 10,000. And we struggle like anything. But who gets the publicity? Bilwara. Only Bilwara, Bilwara. So, we had run this already, and I knew what is the involvement that the organizers have to do to bring up this Bilwara tournament. So, when the Bhopal people told us this, told me that they are going to, what is your experience? I told them my truth. Whatever I knew, I said, I told them. And somebody from there, they went and told Junjunwala. Aaron said like this. So, but still they held it because they were... they had maybe high level connections. BHEL Bhopal, highest people, and Junjunwala, maybe they were friends or something like that. I know nothing about this. They asked me, I told them the truth. So he was, from that time onwards, he was hostile towards me. Then I became secretary of the federation. Already that magazine was there. National Chess Trust of India was bringing up Chess India. So, and Gali was running it first. Gali was a secretary before me, so he was running it. So, I inherited that magazine, and it was once in 3 months. I brought out only one issue in 3 months. First 3 months I brought out. Then I thought, this is nonsense, once in 3 months. There's so much of activities, and so I made it a monthly. And you know who helped me for funding that magazine? Mahalingam, not Junjunwala. Junjunwala did not give anything. I brought out the magazine for him, because I was secretary of the federation, and he was closely associated with the National Chess Trust of India. He's a big name and all that. But he didn't give anything, no advertisements. Advertisements, if you look now, you see there were only Sakti Sugars and Sakti Finance. Advertisements were there. And afterwards I said, I told them we had to buy a typewriter. We didn't even have a typewriter. I was using my portable typewriter. At the time, no computer and all that. I said, we have expanded rapidly. Now there are so many subscribers. I need to buy a typewriter. You give me a typewriter. He said, you should not have expanded so fast. Really? They said like that. We cannot give you the typewriter. So, but the magazine was running at a profit because of Mahalingam support and all that. So, with the profit from that, I bought a typewriter. And at the end, I 1983, when I started this, I gave notice to him. Sorry, sir, from December 1982 onwards, I will not bring out the magazine. You find somebody else. I told them, that was sometime in June, I told them, in December, I am not going to run this anymore. They said, okay. They didn't say okay. They just kept quiet, thinking that I will anyway do it. But I didn't do it. Meanwhile, I launched whatever is to be done for ChessBase as a monthly magazine, registering it, this thing, that thing. And I started in August 22. Many months after that. You know what he said? Aaron has exploited us. With the knowledge gained from running our magazine, he has started his own. And you know, when I told him these are the assets with the Chess India, there were so many issues, unsold issues of this issue, that issue, and some stationery and one typewriter. I had a big time. He said, give us only the typewriter, the rest you keep. He did not want the magazines. He wanted the typewriter. Okay. He was a big man, millionaire. And he told me, there's Vidya Bhavan, there's a magazine, or some famous Hindu magazine. Some magazine is there. He said, the back cover is 15,000 rupees. And there are 10 people waiting for it, for the back cover. And I am one, and I didn't get it. He was willing to pay 10,000, 15,000 for that back cover in Vidya Bhavan, something like some magazine. It's a Hindu-oriented thing, only Hindu-religious thing. Either, but he did not want to give even one advertisement to our Chess, his own magazine, Chessmate, Chess India. So I think this is not a good thing. I quit.
So currently, what do you have to say about chess in India and how happy are you with what's going on? 51st GM just happened yesterday and nearing 100 IMs.
It's good. It's going on good. But everywhere there are some struggles and problems. See, I am now concerned with my district, Thoothukudi district, not Chennai, where I have to bring it up. Because I don't find a single international master from my district. No woman international master, no international master. So I started a trust, Thoothukudi Chess Trust. And I donated some money to it. I am the only fellow to donate. And he said we have to 2 lakhs to anybody who becomes IM. Or a WIM, that sort of thing. And then I sent them a lot of games by email from ChessBase, based on ChessBase. See, whatever I write for the ASF Chronicle and Chessmate, afterwards I send it to them, copies to my players, my prospective players in my district, whom you would have never seen, you have never heard of also. And they don't even come. None of them is playing here in the Chennai Open. Last year, I thought I must sponsor and bring at least one boy or girl from there. But then I found that the rating is very low. How can we ask them? It's about 1600, 1700.
So even at the age of 82, you are trying to work at the grassroots level and promote young talents here. Yeah.
That may be because of my fathers. My father always wanted to do something for the others. Always. And I used to think that he's a mad fellow. Every son thinks about his father as a mad fellow. I am sure Arvind thinks the same of me now.
And you analyze the games of AICF Chronicle, you said also Chessmate. How has chess changed according to you from the times you used to play?
It's more theory driven with a lot of openings and all that. I use ChessBase mainly to find out which are the novelties. I say this is a novelty, I have to put N there and then go on with my own comments of which is strong, which is good, and why it's not. I have seen some players when they write for Chessmate. Arvind sometimes asks some well top grandmasters to write for Chessmate to annotate a game. They do it. But the thing is, they just give a variation. Just a variation, but no conclusion, whether it's good or bad for who, nothing. They think that the reader also knows, like him. They assume that the reader is as good as the IM or GM, and they don't explain anything. So here I make it clear to explain everything, sometimes in words, sometimes in symbols and all that. I enjoy writing. I enjoy annotating games now. And I also bring in a lot of history sometimes about who they are, why they did like this and all that.
Any dreams that you have right now that you would like to be fulfilled?
Pardon me?
Any dreams that you would want to be fulfilled right now that you're working on?
Only to make that IM from
Thoothukudi. Okay.
And I used to travel frequently to Thoothukudi. Because I'm Arjun Award, I have a railway pass. Now I'm going there on 30th for another tournament, 30th. But this time, my wife refused to come along with me. I can take one more person, companion, along with me. But she says, it's not possible for me to, I myself might fall down. How can I help you if you fall? So I have now asked one of my old cousins to come with me, and he's agreed. On 30th, leaving for Thoothukudi for one tournament inauguration and all that.
Thank you, Mr. Manuel Aaron, for this wonderful conversation, and we wish you all the best in your endeavors that you are still so ambitious about.
Yeah, thank you.